Take a look at this picture. They are ordinary people known as the 13th escapees, attempting to flee from Pompeii. While trying to save their lives, a 350-degree Celsius wind instantly wiped them all out. Some were asleep, some praying to the gods while embracing each other, frozen in that moment. So, how did they turn into stone, and what had they experienced in the last 24 hours? Was it a punishment from the gods or just an ordinary natural disaster? Pompeii, a city with a population of 15,000 located on the coastal areas of Italy, was under the Roman Empire in 79 AD. Life in this city, which was more prosperous than other Roman cities due to its volcanic soil, was bustling as usual. Maritime trade had greatly enriched the city, and Pompeii, with its villas for Roman aristocrats, was an ideal location for vacations and escapades. Gladiatorial fights took place in the arenas built a century before the Colosseum in Rome, wild parties were held in brothels, slaves catered to every extravagant need of their masters, people enjoyed leisure time in public baths, and the Forum was a hub for shopping. The architecture and art created by the well-educated Pompeii residents, thanks to their wealth and gateway to the world, were so advanced that they would influence both Europe and, years later, the architecture of America. There were more than 100 taverns and inns where sailors and passengers could spend their time in the city. And, of course, the most profitable profession was baking. In this wall painting, you see the baker Tarandus Neo and his wife from Pompeii. The parchment held by Tarandus Neo, one of the wealthy figures in the city, indicates that his wife is not only present in his life but also in his business. Their happy home is evident, but little did they know that a great disaster was about to befall them. The temples in Pompeii were full of devout Romans. Additionally, Romans not only believed in gods but also dabbled in black magic. One talisman found during excavations contains a spell made by a woman who couldn't share the same man. I dedicate Flammation Fossilius's slave to the gods of hell, his face, hair, mind, breath, vital organs. Thus, you will never have him. May he be angry and hateful towards you. May his testicles be useless so that the girl's insides always remain empty. Although people continued with their daily lives, they were aware that something was going wrong lately. Weeks of ongoing earthquakes had started to create panic among the people. The city's water pipes were damaged, and some of the baths and pools became unusable. More than half of the Pompeii residents, especially the wealthy, had already started to leave the city. However, no one thought that the earthquakes were caused by the movements of the dormant volcano located 8 kilometers away from the city and had been inactive for years. By the time they realized it, it would be too late. And Vesuvius remains the most active volcano on the European mainland, with more than 3 million people living in its vicinity. Hence, it is considered one of the deadliest volcanoes in the world. It also has another historical feature. It is the same volcano where Spartacus hid with his 77 companions, and it has been in a sensitive slumber for quite some time. Now, let's go back together to its awakening 2,000 years ago. Following the eruption of the volcano, the first major explosion in years occurs on the morning of October 24, 79, at 9 a.m. The countdown to doomsday has begun. The city's inhabitants, thrown into the streets with a loud noise, are at a loss to make sense of what is happening. For the Pompeians, this is just the beginning. There is still no reason for them to fear the mountain covered with trees that you currently see, in order to discuss what to do in the face of what they are experiencing. The situation seems temporary, but the terrifying scene created by the volcanic explosion causes another significant portion of the population to flee the city. By noon, Vesuvius erupts for the second time. However, this is a far more catastrophic event than the morning's eruption. This explosion is so massive that its power is thousands of times greater than the atomic bomb dropped on Hiroshima. The volcano begins to spew 100,000 tons of ash, lava, and pumice per second. As a result of the explosion, the roofs of many houses were blown off, and people were thrown from where they stood. Panic ensues in the city, and a 35-kilometer column of lava and ash rises into the sky, creating a horrifying sight. Can you imagine the scene? A colossal heap of lava, ash, and stones rising 35 kilometers from a mountain. By the afternoon, the sky had already been covered with black smoke, and seeing the sun was now impossible. The only thing those who could lift their heads would see was smoke, ash, and stones. The volcano was not only spewing lava and ash, pumice stones ejected from Vesuvius were raining down on Pompeii, forming piles of 30 centimeters on the streets. Thousands of kilometers of black smoke were creating lightning of unimaginable intensity. Picture this, pumice stones and ashes raining down from black smoke that covered the sun, and every second massive lightning bolts painted the sky red. The Pompeians must have thought that the gods were at war with each other. After the second explosion at noon, the people, realizing the severity of the situation, had descended into utter chaos. Those trying to protect themselves from falling stones were running into what they believed to be safe homes with pillows on their heads. Those who could enter their homes were locking their doors to escape looting, and the pumice stones falling on them were no longer as small as they were in the morning, they were larger and harder. In archaeological excavations, the bodies of 396 people who died from the rain of pumice stones in Pompeii have been found. Around 5 p.m. when volcanic debris reached Pompeii, it was still neither hot nor poisonous. Yes, the city was covered with the smoke of the volcano, ash heaps approaching 50 centimeters had accumulated on the streets, and the rain of pumice stones from the sky had increased. However, a deadly and toxic heap had not yet reached the city. Deaths were still occurring due to the rain of stones and the collapse of roofs. It is estimated that a third of Pompeii's victims died from the collapse of roofs. Meanwhile, another city had already disappeared along with its inhabitants. Herculaneum, closer to Mount Vesuvius, was covered with a flow, and the entire population had already perished. The disappearance on every smiling face happened so rapidly that even the eggs and fresh bread you see now remained as they were on the first day. This is shown by the fact that a charred baby from the eruption, unable to live the life that awaited, is still talked about even after 2,000 years. I wonder which one it would prefer. Herculaneum would completely disappear under volcanic debris, be forgotten, and would be accidentally discovered by workers digging the foundations of a summer palace for King Charles of Bourbon in Naples in 1738. But let's get back to our main topic, Pompeii. The story there is much bigger. Despite everything, the Pompeians believed that the situation would improve. In fact, the wealthy even chained their slaves to prevent them from escaping and waited for the disaster to pass. However, the thickness of the black clouds was tens of thousands of meters, their speeds were hundreds of kilometers, and at that time, the majority of the 2,000 people who had not yet left the city were still alive. Look, the man you see in this picture is considered one of the most iconic symbols of Pompeii, thought to be a mule driver. Because when found, the body of the mule was also preserved like him. He succumbed to his fate while trying to force open a locked toilet door. According to archaeologists, despite knocking on the door several times, no one answered, and he surrendered to his fate, taking his last breath under his blanket. We still know that there were people in Pompeii who believed that everything would return to normal on the night between October 24th and 25th. Because people who continued to have fun in the bars had already encountered death here, and the money boxes in the bars were full. Slaves continued to serve their masters. The pumice and ash heaps on the streets had reached 80 centimeters, making walking almost impossible. An unimaginable situation, yet there were still people continuing to have fun. Perhaps this was their own farewell to an accepted helplessness. We will never know. Here is the corrected text, while they continued to have fun, the destructive wave was yet to come. Up to that moment, Pompeii had experienced rain of ash, smoke, and pumice stones, striking with the deadly blow of the devastating gas clouds, hitting the city walls several times at great speed, causing them to crumble. It had given the people of Pompeii a little more time to survive, but in the final massive wave, a cloud of fiery gas at 350 degrees Celsius engulfed the city at a speed of 100 kilometers per hour. The last surviving Pompeians died without even realizing what had happened. It took just a second for them to lose their lives. In their final moments, they felt nothing and saw nothing. The majority of those we see today, eating, sleeping, embracing each other, were the ones who died with this final massive cloud of fire. They remained frozen in their last moments without understanding what had happened, leaving a story for generations 2,000 years later. But we know every minute of the entire process in Pompeii, the fear, the pain, the magnitude of the explosion. This is because one person who witnessed the entire disaster managed to survive. The young conscious Biller, along with his elderly uncle Pelin, came to Pompeii as soon as they heard about the explosion and began to take notes on the developments. The young man describes the events in detail in letters, and it is through this method that the story reaches us today. Until 2022, it was believed that the eruption occurred in August, but with joint research and findings revealed in 2022, we are sure that it happened in October. Both the clothing of the recovered bodies and the vegetables and fruits sold in the disaster roses of the grocers were more suitable for October-November than August. Considering other findings, the definite date is thought to be October 24th and 25th, 79 AD. The rediscovery of the city of Pompeii was, like everything in Hercules, a matter of coincidence. In 1592, workers digging an underground aqueduct in the mills of architect Domenico Fontana hit ancient walls covered with paintings and inscriptions. Yes, this was the lost city of Pompeii. However, it was not given much attention, and excavation work in the region had to wait for about 200 more years. Now, get ready, because the information you are about to learn can change your thoughts about Pompeii from start to finish. We all know the stone-cut people in Pompeii. However, the reason 99% of these people turned to stone is that in the late 1800s, excavators poured plaster into the holes they opened to remove the bodies of Pompeii without disturbing the positions of the bones. So we fossilized most of the people you see, not nature. In Pompeii, a total of 1150 bodies have been unearthed so far, but only 106 of them have been brought to light in the form of molds. The rest were skeletons removed because there was no need for mold casting. It is estimated that around 2,000 people died in the disaster in Pompeii. The majority of the deceased were elderly and sick, or selfless children who did not want to leave their families. There were also forcibly held slaves. Very few wealthy people did not escape from Pompeii and died. The Pompeii disaster was one of the most dramatic scenes in history. This is clear, but today the disaster has left us with the most preserved city of the Roman world, the archaeological excavation site where we can get closest to the world of ancient times. There is no other ancient city in the world today that has been preserved as much as Pompeii. We owe this to the ashes of Vesuvius. So, we owe it to this disaster. Take a close look at this house. It is called the Villa of Mysteries. Its walls are covered with Roman religious drawings and the happy days of the family. But the only thing left from it is this little girl. This, I say, is the Villa of Mysteries, currently a ruined debris, but look at its splendor from those years. What remains of it are 36 bodies in the basement of the house. Probably 18 women and children, likely servants, had breathed their last breaths embracing each other. Life is full of disasters, pains, and sorrows. Even though 2,000 years have passed, they were humans just like us, experiencing all of these. They had emotions, families, love for each other, and dreams. Many were innocent, many were poor, many were hopeless people. This was not a punishment from the gods. Many who would be punished by the gods had already left the city, the wicked had triumphed again, and the innocent had perished.